Hello, I'm Marion. I've got a story for you today, and it comes from Peterborough Museum, and it's about a big Jurassic fish. You might ask, what's a fish doing swimming around Peterborough? Well, did you know that millions of years ago, in Jurassic times, the whole of this part of the country was under a sea, a deep Jurassic sea? Bit like this one. There were some pretty strange creatures swimming around in that sea. Like this one. It's an ichthyosaur. Issy the ichthyosaur. Can you see her sharp eyes? And her long, inquisitive nose. She loves looking at things and finding stuff out. One day, Issy was swimming around in the Jurassic Sea among the multicoloured mollusks and the shells and the seaweed. She found something she'd never seen before. Little brown fish. "What type of fish are you?" said Issy.
"I don't know," said the little brown fish. "I can't remember, and I'm lost, and I can't find my mummy."
And the little brown fish began to cry. Issy didn't like that. And then she had an idea. "I'm Issy the ichthyosaur with sharp eyes and a long inquisitive nose. I'm just the person to help you find your mum. Come along." So Issy and the little brown fish went swimming off to look for the little brown fish's mother. They hadn't gone far when they saw something very strange. "What's that there?" said Issy. "A little head on a long, long neck." Big, strong paddles for swimming. It's Peter the plesiosaur. Peter the plesiosaur's always hungry. He's always looking for something to eat. His favourite food, crunchy ammonites. He spotted one. Crunch, crunch. "Perhaps you're a plesiosaur," said Issy to the little brown fish. "Do you like crunching ammonites?" The little fish didn't know. "I'll try," he said. "Here's an ammonite. Let's give it a crunch. Crunch. Help! Help!" "I don't think the ammonite likes it. I don't think I am a plesiosaur," said the little brown fish. "Well, where are you then?" said Issy. "Uh-oh, I hope you're not a crunching crocodile." The little brown fish didn't know what a crunching crocodile was either. "Oh, crunching crocodile, she's terrible. She's big and she's green and she's got huge eyes and she's got sharp white teeth. And oh no, she's right behind you!" Snap, snap, snap. Well, the little brown fish, he escaped from crunching crocodile, "but I don't think I'll ever find my mummy," he said. "Oh, don't give up," said Issy the ichthyosaur. And on they swam far along through the deep Jurassic Sea until
What's down there in that cave?
Said Issy.
Something big moving around. And a big shining eye.
And there came a huge fish.
Mummy!
Said the little brown fish.
Little brown fish, where have you been? I've been looking everywhere,
said the mother fish.
Mummy, I've met Issy the ichthyosaur and Peter the plesiosaur and Crunching Crocodile, and I've forgotten what kind of fish I am.
You are a Leedsichthys, just like me.
A Leedsichthys.
I'm a Leedsichthys.
Mummy, will I get as big as Issy the ichthyosaur?
Little Leedsichthys, you will get just as big as me. Pretty big fish, eh? That's the story of the big Jurassic fish. And you know, we know about all the creatures in that story because people have found their fossil bones deep under the ground. And you can see them in Peterborough Museum. An ichthyosaur, a plesiosaur, a prehistoric crocodile, and a small part of Peterborough's own fish, the Leedsichthys. They didn't find a whole Leedsichthys, and that's quite a good thing, because if they'd got the entire fish in the museum, there wouldn't be room for anything else. Also, if you go to Peterborough Museum, you can find the book that that story came out of. I hope you get there soon. But until we go to the museum, you could always have some Jurassic fun at home. You can make your own Jurassic sea like me. I just made it out of cardboard and paint, a bit of bubble wrap. I found things from all over the place. Ooh. Ages ago, someone knitted me this ammonite. And as for Crunching Crocodile, I borrowed her from Sam and Molly. Thank you, Sam and Molly. Maybe you could make your own Leedsichthys. I wonder what your one will look like and how big it will be. Thank you to Peterborough Museum for letting me share this story with you. And thank you for listening. Bye.